In this class, we are going to discuss about elimination of left factoring. Elimination of left factoring. We can say that a grammar contains left factoring if it contains production rules in the form of A implies alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2, so on, gamma 1, gamma 2, so on. So if a grammar contains production rule like this, then we can say that the grammar contains left factoring. Here the problem is the top-down parsers cannot handle the grammars which contains left factoring. So we have to eliminate the left factoring. So here we can eliminate the left factoring by replacing with the following productions. So in order to eliminate this left factoring, we have to use some productions. Here the first production is A implies alpha A dash or gamma 1 or gamma 2, where A dash implies beta 1 or beta 2, so on. So A implies alpha A dash or gamma 1 or gamma 2, where A dash implies beta 1 or beta 2, so on. Now let's see some examples. So let's see example 1. S implies IETS or IETSES or epsilon. E implies B. So let us write the first production. S implies IETS or IETS ES or A. So here out of these two productions, IETS is the common term here. So we can assume IETS as alpha. Here beta 1 is nothing but epsilon, and this ES is nothing but the second production, that is nothing but beta 2. This A is nothing but gamma 1. So we can say that this grammar contains left factoring. So in order to eliminate the left factoring, we have to replace this grammar with these two productions. The first production is A implies alpha A dash or gamma 1 or gamma 2, where A dash implies beta 1 or beta 2, so on. So here let's write the first production. A implies, here what is A here? So this one is nothing but A here. So S implies alpha A dash. Here alpha is nothing but IETS A dash. A dash is nothing but S dash. Next R, gamma 1. Here gamma 1 is nothing but A, and we don't have gamma 2 here, where A dash implies, so A dash means S dash implies beta 1 or beta 2. Here beta 1 is nothing but epsilon, because anything into epsilon is nothing but that anything, okay. So here let us assume that beta 1 is nothing but epsilon. So epsilon comma R. Next beta 2. Beta 2 is nothing but ES, okay. So this is the first production. Here if you take the second production, here there is no left factoring here. So there is no need to replace this production with some productions. So after eliminating the left factoring, the productions are, this is the first production, and this is the second production, and this is the third production, okay. So first production, second production, and third production. We have to write this production also, because this production doesn't contains no left factoring, okay. Now let us eliminate left factoring for this example. So A implies small a, capital A, capital B, or small a, capital A, or small a. B implies small b, capital B, or small b. So let us take the first production. So A implies small a, capital A, capital B, or small a, capital A, or small a. So out of these three projections, the common term is A. The common term is A. So we have to assume that common term as alpha. So alpha is nothing but A. Next, beta 1 is nothing but AB. Beta 2 is nothing but A. Beta 3 is nothing but epsilon. So we can say that this projection contains left factoring. So in order to eliminate the left factoring, we have to replace this projection with these two projections. So now let us write the first one. So this is nothing but A. So this is in the form of A implies alpha beta 1, alpha beta 2, alpha beta 3. So here beta 3 is nothing but epsilon. Why? Because anything into epsilon is nothing but anything. Here we don't have any gamma 1 and gamma 2 values here. All are common terms only. So we have to replace with A implies. So A is nothing but A. A implies alpha A dash. Here what is alpha? A is nothing but alpha A dash. So A dash is nothing but A dash. We don't have gamma 1 and gamma 2. Okay. Where A dash implies beta 1 or beta 2. So what is beta 1 here? AB. Or beta 2 imply, beta 2 means capital A, beta 3 means epsilon. So after eliminating left factoring for this projection, so these two are the resultant projections. Now let us consider the second projection. So what is the second projection? B implies BB or B. So in this projection, B is the common term in the two projections. So we can assume B as alpha. So B is nothing but beta 1. So here there is no term here. So we have to assume epsilon as beta 2 value. So this one is nothing but A. So we can say that this grammar contains left factoring. So we have to eliminate the left factoring here by replacing with these two projections. So what is the first projection here? A implies alpha A dash. Here what is A? B implies alpha A dash. Here alpha is nothing but B. Next, A dash is nothing but B dash. And we don't have any gamma 1, gamma 2 here. So where B dash implies? A dash implies beta 1 or beta 2. So what is beta 1 here? B. Next, beta 2 means epsilon. So after eliminating the left factoring for this projection, the resultant projections are these two projections. So now, after eliminating the left factoring for this grammar, the resultant projections are, the first one is A implies A dash. Second production is A dash implies AB or A or epsilon. Third one is B implies BB dash. Fourth one is B dash implies B or epsilon. So now let's see two more examples in this concept. Now let us solve these two examples. So we have to eliminate left factoring for these two grammars. So here the first grammar is x implies x plus x or x star x or d. So here the common term in the right hand side is x. So we have to assume this x as alpha. Why? Because alpha is nothing but the common term. So next, beta 1 is nothing but plus x. Beta 2 is nothing but star x. So what about d? D is nothing but gamma 1. So we can say that this grammar contains left factoring. So we have to eliminate the left factoring for this grammar. So in order to eliminate the left factoring for this grammar, we have to replace this grammar with these two projections. So what is the first projection? A implies alpha A dash. Here A is nothing but x. So x implies alpha A dash. So alpha means x. So A dash means x dash. Okay. Or what is gamma 1 here? Gamma 1 means D. So we don't have gamma 2 here. Next, where A dash implies? So A is nothing but x. So x dash implies beta 1 or beta 2. So beta 1 means plus x. Or beta 2 means star x. Okay. So after eliminating the left factoring in this grammar, so these two are the resultant productions. And what is the next one? D implies 1 or 2 or 3. So here there is no left factoring. So there is no need to perform any replacement here. So after eliminating the left factoring for this grammar, the resultant productions are, so this is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. So now let's see the last example in left factoring. So here the grammar contains two productions. The first production is E implies T plus E or T. So here we have two productions. T plus E is first production, T is the second production. So here the common term is T. So we have to assume this T as alpha. So plus E is nothing but beta 1. Here we don't have any beta 2. So we have to assume epsilon as beta 2 value. So this one is nothing but A. So we can say that our grammar contains left factoring. So we have to replace this grammar with these two productions. So here the first production is A implies alpha A dash. So A means E implies alpha A dash. So alpha means T. Next A dash means E dash or gamma 1. Here we don't have gamma 1 and gamma 2. So there is no need to write here. So where A dash implies, so A dash means E dash implies beta 1. So beta 1 means plus E or beta 2 means epsilon. So this is the resultant here. Now let us consider the last production. So what is the last production here? T implies int R int star T or left parenthesis E right parenthesis. So here we have three productions. So two production contains one common term. So that one is nothing but int. So we have to assume int as alpha. So alpha is nothing but int. So beta 1 means epsilon, whereas beta 2 means star 2. So this left parenthesis E right parenthesis is nothing but gamma 1. So this one is nothing but the starting non-terminal. That one is nothing but capital A. So we can say that this production contains left factoring. So we have to eliminate the left factoring. So in order to eliminate the left factoring, we have to replace this production with these two productions. So what is the first production? A implies, here A means T implies alpha A dash. So alpha means int, A dash means T dash, or gamma 1 or gamma 2. So gamma 1 means left parenthesis E, right parenthesis. Here we don't have gamma 2 here. Where A dash implies, so what is A here? T. So T dash implies beta 1 or beta 2. So here beta 1 is nothing but epsilon. Or beta 2 is nothing but star T. Okay. So after eliminating the left factoring for this grammar, the resultant productions are, this is the first production, this is the second production, and this is the third production, and this is the fourth production. So this is about left factoring.